Hello students, today in this session we are going to see about the control and coordination. Now we know that all living organisms including plants and animals respond and react to the changes occurring in the environment around them, right? So one by one we will discuss now how control and coordination takes place in animals and plants. Now first of all, what is stimuli? Stimuli means the changes in the environment to which all living organisms respond. The example for this can be heat, cold, sound, smell, etc. You know, sometimes for example we can say if a man touches a very hot utensil accidentally, he pulls quickly away his hand, right? So here heat acts as a stimuli to which the response is taken in the form of body movements. We move our hand suddenly when we touch a hot plate, right? So this is nothing but stimuli. Next comes the coordination. Now, working together of various organs in an organism to produce a proper response to a stimuli means the whenever any, you can, the example just I have told you about the hot plate. We can also take an example of like when we see sun. Sun is very bright, we suddenly close our eyes. Okay, so light acts as an stimulus and we react by closing our eyes. So our eyes coordinate, like in this example and first examples, our hand suddenly moves away. So that is also coordination. Now in animals, nervous system and endocrine systems are involved for the proper coordination in animals, and in plants, plant hormones and phytohormones play a role in the coordination. Okay. Now let's see first of all the coordination in plants. You know, for maintaining the coordination in plants, plants coordinate behavior against environmental changes with the help of chemical substances, like they are also called as plant hormones or phytohormones. Now these hormones mainly are of five types, and you know, hormones are mainly responsible for the growth in the plants. Okay, now they can be also called as plant growth substances. Okay, now let's see one by one the hormones. First example is the auxins. Auxins helps in the cell division, cell elongation and growth of plants. Okay. Next is the gibberellins. Gibberellins hormones helps in the growth of stems and branches. Next comes the cytokinins. Cytokinins helps in the cell division, formation of fruits and seeds. So from this we can say like phytohormones or plant hormones play different role. Different hormones play different role in the growth of plants. Next is the abscisic acid. This helps in the growth and affects the wilting of leaves. That means students, what happens, sometimes it promotes the dormancy in seeds and buds. That means it is complete opposite of, you can say, opposite of breaking of dormancy. It also promotes closing of stomata. Okay, and it also causes a detachment of flowers and fruits from the plants. That also for, you can say, acts also as growth inhibitor, right? Next comes the ethylene. Ethylene helps in the flowering and ripening of fruits. So students, in this session we have seen about the hormones which play an important role in the growth of plants. And next session we will see how movements take place in plants. Thank you.